Good morning, Pam Drzewicki here. Oh, what a spectacular day out there today. Spectacular. I was just spending some time on my front porch this morning, where when the weather is beautiful, I love to enjoy reading, meditating, praying. And a new practice that I started today was to just sit silent, for 5 minutes. Set the timer and sat there for 5 minutes and just sat silent. The exercise is for me to be able to calm my brain down and just be. Now, it's not easy, so that's the reason why I start in small increments. So I'm so excited about this, because after doing this piece that I put out in my newsletter this week about filling our self-worth bank, it made so much sense to me that in order for us to fill our self-worth bank, that we need to sit silent so we could understand who we are and how we're showing up. When we're not depositing in our self-worth bank, what ends up happening? And what is a self-worth bank? Do you know what that is? It really is a place that we put deposits, like as if we were going to the bank and putting money in. We're putting deposits in for our confidence and our well-being. So if we don't have the time to just sit silent for 5 minutes, what are we saying to ourselves that we're worth, right? We are worth so much more than that. So when we're depositing in the self-worth bank, there's a couple of things that are really important. Being kind to ourselves and what we tell ourselves of who we are and how we're acting. That's number one. Being connected to your higher power, in my case, God. So sitting silent for 5 minutes and just being in the moment and trying to listen to what is being told to me and not what the outside static is about. That's, you know, depositing in my self-worth bank. Taking good care of our bodies. What we eat, our movement, our exercise is really important too. So there are so many ways that we could really contribute to that. And starting at a young age and helping our children and younger generation understand about the importance in putting in the self-worth bank is key in helping them get to the next level. Now, when I was a teenager, there wasn't a lot of deposits going on in my self-worth bank. And because of that, decisions that I had made truly probably weren't the best decisions, right? So as I got older and an adult, I still was in the process of not depositing into my self-worth bank. And it just really made me, again, probably not make the best choices. But over time, I started learning about confidence and that I am enough and I am worth depositing into my self-worth bank. Is what made a difference in my life. Now, this came later on in life, and it's okay because I really bless the fact that it has come into my life. What are you depositing into your self-worth bank? What are you doing? I would love to hear what that is, because it truly matters what you say and what you do. Until next time, Pam Drzewicki, take back your life and have it be a wonderful one.